Well, hello. Got a little project here today, making a dog bed. And I've had issues before. I bought these cots. I bought all kinds of different things. We've got all kinds of different things to use. And the problem that I have is I want something that's comfortable, that's like has a fabric on it, and is going to be last a long time and doesn't have a whole bunch of pull off. So basically what I did was I decided I was gonna make this piece, and I got this 21 inches over here, and I got that 36. And obviously if you're gonna do this, you're gonna be able to do something along those lines. Then I went to Home Depot and I bought 3-foot roll. So basically the bed itself, sorry for moving in the camera, the bed itself is total overall length of 24 by 36. So what did I do? I bought exactly 1 yard, 36 inches in width of roll, and I had them cut that for me, and it was 12 feet long. There's a piece over there. It was 12 feet long. So basically that piece there is 4 yards, okay? And this piece was 4 yards. And what have I done? I made the frame, okay, by cutting the 2x4s and nailing it together. And then I stretched it over this fabric here. So basically, here's the inside. And so nothing's gonna scratch the floor. It's real light. You know, and if the carpet gives out, because I've done this before, if the carpet gives out, I just pull it off and staple another one on the frame. But, you know, just using some, I'm using these, I wish I had an electric stapler, but I got an air stapler. And whatever the length of the staples are, they're not very long, like maybe a little over 1/2 inch or something. But anyway, just an idea if you want to make a dog bed, it isn't that hard. So here's all that happens is this piece is the last piece left over from that. You just get it centered, then pull it up. Staple, pull it up, staple, pull it up, staple, cut the corners and staple it over. So it's like wrapping a Christmas present. If you can do that, you can do this. So anyway, good luck. Let me know if you like it. With the way I figured this, that's what's left over for scrap with the 2x4s. The carpet scrapping, that little bit that you're seeing right there, that's it. Basically, I just laid this frame on top of the carpet centered. Then I stapled it best I could on this end and that end, okay? And then I cut it so I could fold in the edges. I'm gonna do this one over here. Over here, I'm gonna do this one. Notice that when you cut this, you wanna cut it straight. But then here, you wanna cut this at a little bit of an angle so that it doesn't bunch up, so it folds over nice and clean. So basically, you just get it tacked in, and then you can go crazy with the stapler after you're done.